السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
بسم الله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون ويقول يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا ويقول أيضا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد أيها الناس الله عز وجل revealed the Quran as a guidance whose light does not turn off and a lamp whose fire is not extinguished a way that those following it do not go astray and a might that those supporting it are not defeated For it is the material of Iman and the fountain of knowledge and an infinite spring for those who take from it. And Allah Almighty made it a quencher for the thirst of scholars and a spring for the hearts of the wise and a medicine after which there is no disease. It is Allah's firm rope, the wise reminder and straight path. It has the stories of those before us and the news of those after us. It is the truth and not amusement. And with the truth, he sent it. And with the truth, it descended. Whoever acts upon it is rewarded. And whoever judges by it is just. And whoever calls to it is guided to the straight path. Whoever asks for guidance from it, Allah honors him. And whoever seeks guidance from other than it, Allah Almighty will disgrace him. Through it, Allah Almighty raises people and lowers others. As Allah says in Surah Al-Mujadala, وَإِذَا قِيلَ انْشُزُوا فَانْشُزُوا يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And when you are told, arise, then arise. Allah will raise those who have believed among you and those who are given knowledge by degrees. And Allah is all aware of what you do. And it will come as an intercessor for its people on the day of Qiyamah. And Abi Umama رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. Abu Umama رضي الله عنه reported, I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, read the Quran as it will come as an intercessor for its companion on the day of resurrection. Indeed, the book of Allah is like the soul for life and light for guidance. Whoever does not recite it and act upon it is not truly alive. They are dead, whether they speak or act or come and go. And whoever does not believe in it has strayed and is not guided. Allah Almighty says, أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ كَمَنْ مَثَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِّنْهَا. And is one who was dead and we gave him life and made for him light by which to walk among the people like the one who is in darkness, never to emerge therefrom. A person without Qur'an is like life without water and air. This is because the Quran is the medicine and the cure. Allah Almighty says, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we send down of the Quran that which is healing and mercy for the believers, but it does not increase the wrongdoers except in loss. And Allah says,
قُلْ هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هُدًى وَشِفَاءٌ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ فِي آذَانِهِمْ وَقْرٌ وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِمْ عَمًى.
Say, it is for those who believe a guidance and cure, and those who do not believe in their ears is deafness, and it is upon them blindness. Allah Almighty says again,
وَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ جَعَلْنَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ حِجَابًا مَسْتُورًا.
And when you recite the Qur'an, we put between you and those who do not believe in the hereafter a hidden barrier. A Muslim is surprised by the stance of many people in front of the Book of Allah while they have been surrounded by darkness from every direction. It is truly surprising that they have the light between their hands, yet they still follow the footsteps of the misguided in every path and way, unable to find a path to guidance. And Allah says,
يَعْمَلُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِّنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ.
They know what is apparent of the worldly life, but they of the hereafter are unaware. Umar radiallahu anhu said, Ayyuhal Nas, there was a time when I thought that whoever recites the Quran seeks only Allah and nothing else. But I have been told that there are people who recite the Quran seeking what people have. So seek the pleasure of Allah through your recitation and your action. Allah has sent down the Quran for contemplation and reflecting upon it, not merely for reciting it while the heart is distracted and heedless. Allah Almighty says,
كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ.
This is a blessed book which we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they might reflect upon its verses and that those of understanding would be reminded. Allah Almighty says, أَفَلَمْ يَدَّبَّرُوا الْقَوْلِ أَمْ جَاءَهُمْ مَا لَمْ يَأْتِ آبَاءَهُمُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. Then have they not reflected over the word of the Qur'an, or has there come to them that which had not come to their forefathers? Allah Almighty says again, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Then do they not reflect upon the Qur'an, if it had been from any other than Allah, they would have found within it much contradiction. Allah Almighty says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Then do they not reflect upon the Qur'an, or are their locks upon their hearts? Al-Hasan al-Basri, may Allah have mercy on him, said that the Qur'an was sent down for contemplating and acting upon it. So recite it and act upon it. Allah also says in Surah Al-Hadid, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ وَلَا يَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَلُ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. Has the time not come for those who have believed that their hearts should become humbly submissive at the remembrance of Allah and what has come down to the truth, and let them not be like those who were given the scripture before and a long period passed over them, so their hearts hardened and many of them are defiantly disobedient. So what is wrong with our hearts? What is this hard-heartedness when reciting the words of Allah? What are these locks on the hearts? What is this veil over the hearts? Have our hearts become harder than stone? Indeed, if this Qur'an were to be set down upon a mountain, it would humble itself and split out of fear of Allah. As Allah says, ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَٰلِكَ فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَشَّقَّقُ فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَاءُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَهْبِطُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. Then your hearts become hardened, being like stones, or even harder, for indeed there are stones from which rivers burst forth, and there are some of them that split open and water comes out, and there are some of them that fall down because of the fear of Allah, and Allah is not unaware of what you do. We seek refuge in Allah from hardness of the heart, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us remain steadfast upon our faith. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أيها المسلمون, there is nothing more beneficial to a person in this life and the hereafter and to their salvation and happiness than contemplating and pondering upon the Quran and looking at it for a long time. It shows the reciter of the meanings of good and evil and the condition of its people, and shows the reality of this worldly life, and presents the previous communities and nations that have passed, describes Allah's punishment of them. By contemplating and pondering upon the Quran, a person lives with the hereafter as if they are in it, and is absent from this world as if they are out of it. Allah says, Allah نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله. Allah has sent down the best statement, a consistent book. The skins shiver therefrom of those who fear their Lord, then their skins and their hearts relax at the remembrance. O Allah, make the Quran the wellspring of our hearts and the lights of our chest and the banisher of our worries and the reliever of our sorrows. هَذَا وَصَلُّوا وَسَلِّمُوا عَلَى نَبِيِّكُمْ كَمَا أَمَرَكُمْ بِذَلِكَ رَبُّكُمْ فَقَالْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك وإنه لا يذل من واليت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك عبدك ونبيك ونعوذ بك من شر ما عاد به عبدك ونبيك. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.